the second chapter in your maths, that is fractions and decimals. What is fraction? Fraction is a number which represents a part of whole. A part of whole. The whole may be a single object or a group of objects, isn't it? Now, if in one whole object, if I try to shade the half part of it, so I divide it in two parts. All right. Now, if I have to know the fraction part of this one block, all right, so that is the number of part taken upon total number is 2. 1 and 2 means total is 2. So half of each is divided. So upon total number of part, that is 2. Means 1 upon 2. This you must have studied before as well. So half part is shaded. We say it half. 1 by 2, we say it half. Half part is shaded and half part is unshaded. Now, similarly with this, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 blocks are there in which 2 blocks are shaded one. So, the number of parts taken, if we are you are taking 2 parts, so 2 upon total number of part as a whole means 1, 2, 3, 4 upon 4 means 2 upon 4. This upon is a division line. This we say it as numerator. This part, which is down part, this we represent as denominator. All right. Now, the denominator should not be equal to zero. It should not be zero, because if the denominator will be zero, then the fraction is undefined or it has no meaning. Remember this. Now, classification of fractions. Proper fraction. Proper fractions are those fractions in which denominator is greater than numerator and numerator is greater than zero. Similarly, with this, denominator is also greater than zero. For example, look over here. 3 is the numerator, 7 is the denominator. So 7 is greater than 3. It means denominator is greater than numerator. And this is not a zero. All right. So it is a proper fraction. Another example. Denominator is greater than numerator. So it's a proper fraction. Now about improper. Improper fraction, a fraction whose numerator is equal to or greater than its denominator is called an improper fraction. Either it can be equal or it will be more than the denominator, this numerator. All right. So that we say it as a improper fraction. For example, look over here, numerator part. Numerator is greater than denominator, isn't it? Look over here. The another example, 419 is greater than 38. 419 is numerator, 38 is denominator. Clear? Now mixed fraction. Here, we can write like this. If I write this, numerator is greater than denominator or equal to denominator, but not less than. Now mixed fraction consists of two parts, a whole number and a proper fraction. Whole number you have already studied, which contains zero and rest all the natural numbers, isn't it? Now, for example, if you take here, this is a proper fraction where numerator is smaller than the denominator. if we take 0 over here, if we take 0 over here as a whole number, it won't affect this. So it is not a mixed fraction. Look over here. This is the divisor. The denominator is a divisor. This part is a dividend. Now if we try to divide it, 7 into 0 gives you 0. If we minus, the remainder itself will be the same of the dividend. Alright. So here this dividend rule apply, which will not affect the proper mixed fraction, which is not with this 3 by 7, we can't say it's a mixed fraction. We will be saying it as a proper fraction. But if we add 1 over here, let's start with 1. Surely it's a mixed fraction, isn't it? Now take this example. If you take 10 upon 7, it means if you have to divide 10 by 7. So look over here. 7 is the divisor, 10 is the dividend. Now 7 into 1 is 7. So 1 is the quotient, and if you minus it, 3 will be the remainder. So look over here. 1 is in the middle part, which is the quotient, and 3 is the remainder part, and 7 is the divisor. So 7 into 1 plus 3. This rule you have already studied in class 3rd or in class 4th. Dividend is equals to quotient into divisor plus remainder. Now 7 into 1 is 7 plus 3 gives 10. 10 upon 3. So we can write in this form. This we say it as a mixed form. Now here it is a mixture of natural number and the proper fraction. Now we can summarize that every mixed fraction can be written as improper fraction and vice versa. Now this improper fraction can be written in this mixed fraction, and this mixed fraction can be written as improper fraction, and vice versa means just the reverse. It means that every improper fractions can be written as mixed fraction as well. Clear? Now the decimal fractions. Any decimal numbers has a decimal fraction. Remember this. For example, if I took this, we can represent by multiplying at both ends, in numerator and denominator part. If we assume this as 1 divided by 1, because the result won't affect. So if we try to multiply with 100 on the numerator part and denominator part, we will get this. Here the denominators is in 100. So in decimal form, the denominators can be in the form of tens. I mean 10, 100, 1000 and so on. That fraction we say it as decimal fraction. Clear? Now about vulgar fraction. Vulgar fraction, look over here. It is also known as common fraction. A vulgar fraction is one where the numerator and denominator are both integers and not fractions. Remember this. Integers can be positive or negative. So here the numerator, this 7, and denominator as 14, they both are having a positive integers. So it is a vulgar fraction. But if we put here any fraction form, suppose that if we take 7 by 2 upon 14, then this whole part is not a vulgar fraction. Remember this. Look over here. If instead of 7, if I write half is a fraction form. Alright. Now upon 4. 4 is a positive integer, but this part is numerator part is in fraction form. It means it is not a vulgar fraction. Now about like fractions. When two or more fractions having same denominator, I took the example of proper and improper fractions. Here two examples of proper fractions where the denominator where the denominator is bigger than the numerator. This we say it as proper, where the numerator is bigger than the denominator. It's an improper fraction. Over here, the denominators are same. We say it as like fractions. It is generally used for the comparison. Now about unlike fractions. When two or more fractions having different denominators, look over here, 1 upon 2, now 2 upon 3, 7 upon 5, 9 upon 7, 2, 3, 5, 7, they all are different. So it is an unlike fraction. Now about equivalent. They have the same value even though they may look different. Same value, how? Look over here, before that, just look the diagram over here. See, this is a circle. If I divide a circle into two parts, this shaded part is the half, 1/2. We can write in fraction form like this, isn't it? Total number is 2 and this part is a 1, so 1 upon 2. So if we take 4 parts in which 2 parts are shaded, 2/4. In this 8, out of 8 parts, 4 parts are shaded, 4/8. But if you try to make it in a simpler form, they all will be having 1/2, which is the minimum. 1/2, 1/2, 1/2. So it's an equivalent fraction, isn't it? Now, look over here. For example, 1 is half. Half is there. If you multiply 1 with both the ends, it will remain the same. But if you take 2, after that 2, 2 if you multiply both the end, it will look like 2 upon 4. If you multiply with 3, it will look like 3/6. So 1/2, 2/4, 3/6, they all are equivalent when you will make it into the simpler form. Clear? And how to make it in a simpler form? You have to divide the same number on in the numerator side and as well as in the denominator side. That process we say it as cancellation or cancelling. If you are dividing the same number in the numerator and the denominator side, that we say it as cancelling. And after cancelling, here with 2, here with 3, if you are dividing, the answer will be 1/2 only, which here it is shown, which shows that this particular fraction is an equivalent fraction. One more way, if suppose two fractions are given. If two fractions are given, we can do cross multiplication. You know, this side to multiply with this, this side multiplied with this. And if the both the LHS and RHS are equal, it means that that particular combination of fraction is an equivalent. Clear? Now the basic property of fraction. If the numerator and denominator of a fraction is multiplied by the same or non-zero number, the value of fraction does not change. Remember this, that what I have already explained. Multiply or divide with the same number, it will not affect the fraction, value of fraction. For example, look over here, multiply and division part. Here you have multiplied. Look, multiplied with 1, 2 and 3. And after making it into a simpler form, they will be having 1/2 only. And this is for division. If you divide with the same number in the numerator and denominator part, the answer is the same. So this is a basic property. If you divide or multiply with the same numbers apart other than zero, so it won't affect the value of fraction. Now if you are having more than two fractions and if you have to calculate whether the fractions are equivalent or not, so for that you have to take, if I take conversion of more than two fractions to equivalent, if you take unlike fractions, they are the unlike fractions where the denominators are not same. So we say it as unlike fraction. Now to convert unlike fraction into like fractions, we have to take we have to make the denominator common by taking a lowest common factor or least common factor, that is LCM. Now 25, 10 and 40, we will take LCM. This is the way to do the LCM part. We will take 2 first. We will do try to divide with 2 as many times as it does not as the number can't be divisible by 2 till here. Then after the lowest number 3, we cannot divide 4. There is we can't divide 25, 5 or 5. Then we will take 5. We will do, and the LCM after that we will multiply the whole division numbers, and the answer will come 200. Now 200 we will take as a denominator. That will be a like we are trying to convert into unlike into like. So for that we are taking the LCM method. Now this 200 is there. Now 25 into 8 gives you 200. So 8 is here. We will multiply with 7. Here we will use here with 10. 10 is this. 20 times it becomes 200. So 20 into the numerator part we will multiply, then with 45 times with 19 into 5. Now here look over here, the denominators are same, means it now it turns into a like fractions. Now it is easy for us to compare it. Now after converting into equivalent like fraction, we can arrange in ascending and descending order. Now when the denominators are same, it is very easy for us to change the orders. Now this is the smallest, after that this 95, then 180. So it is in ascending order. Similarly, now after making this order, we can make it into a simpler form. The answer will come 7/25, 19/40, 9/10. Similarly, for the decimal for the descending order, from highest to the lowest, the highest is 180, then 95, then 56 is coming. Then again we will make it into a simpler form, 9/10, 19/40 and 7/25. This is the descending order. So to arrange the orders as well, we have to make the fraction into a like fractions, and then only. So unlike, try to convert unlike fraction into like fraction by taking the lowest common method. All right, now for addition and subtraction of fractions. Now you have already studied in class 6 in BODMAS that within the braces you have to perform the operation first. So take the LCM of 2 and 3, that is 6, because they both are prime numbers. So 6, now 2 into 3 gives 6. So 3 will multiply with 3, that will give 9. 3 into 2 will give gives you 6. So 2 into the numerator part, 2, that is 2 into 2 is 4. 9 plus 4 gives 13 upon 6. Similarly, do this operation, 6 and 12, the LCM will be 12. Here the operations are done. How to find the LCM? 12. Now 6 into 2 gives 12. 2 will be multiplied with 7. 4 into 3 gives 12. 3 will into 3 will give you 9. 14 plus 9, that is 23 upon 12. Now remove the braces. Do the subtraction part. Now here the common factor is 12. It is from, look over here. Now you have to take LCM of 6 and 12. So 12 will be the LCM. Here have done it, 12 and 6. So 12, now 6 into 2 is gives you 12. 2 into 13, 13 is the numerator part, you will multiply it. Here also, now 26 minus 23, that is 3, the answer will be coming 3/12. Now you have to make it into a simpler form, reduce it to the simplest form. Now 3, you will divide 3 to both the side. 3 divided by 3 give you 1. 3 12 divided by 3 will give you 4. 1/4 will be the answer. Clear? Now multiplication of fractions. Now this is a mixed fraction, isn't it? 3, 2 by 3 into 1, 1 by 2 into 2, 2 by 11. Now you have to convert this mix into improper fraction. After improper fraction, you can do the cancellation part. That part is very easy for you to understand, or you try to divide the same number, the upper and the lower part. No matter whether you are dividing it here, you can divide it to the another fraction also in multiplication. The answer will come after solving 12. Now, second question, 3 upon 100 of 5 liter. Now, here you have to convert 5 liter into milliliter to get the more appropriate answer. You can do it with 3. Now, this of, we know it, that to it is when we are doing the operation, it converts into multiplication sign. So, you can do it. 3 into 5 upon 100, that is 0.15 liter. But to make it more easy, we can convert into ml, as we know that 1 liter is equals to 1000 ml. Alright, so try to convert into simplest form and then cancel the two zeros this side, or divide with 100 numerator and the denominator part. Then 10 will be left over here. 3 into 5 is 15 and into 10 is 150 ml. Clear? Now division of fractions. Division of fractions are very easy. Just you have to follow these 4 steps. Change, flip, multiply and simplify. Change means you have to convert this mixed into improper fraction. After making it into improper fraction, we can flip it. Flip means reciprocal. When this one fraction, always try to keep this side of fraction fixed and try to flip, means change. This 17 by 4, when we try to multiply it, 4 will come on the numerator part and 17 will come on the denominator part. That we say it as flip. Flip divisors into a reciprocal. Reciprocal is there. Reciprocal is nothing, just the denominator will become the numerator and numerator will become the denominator part. Now do the multiplication. Try to multiply it and then make it into a simpler form, or directly simplify it from here itself. After from here, you can directly simplify. 2 into 2, 17 into 3. 3 into 2 is 6. Or try to multiply 51 into 4, that is 204 upon 34. Then you can cancel it with 6. 34 into 6 is 204. This way, both. Whichever way you find convenient, you can do it. Now come on the decimal part. Now here, you have already studied in class 5th and in class 6th. How to write the number, how to read the number. How will you read the number? 929.312, isn't it? So this is the way to read this. The way is more common. There is one more way. All right. Now this expanded form, how to write? 9 into 100 plus 2 into 10 into 9 into 1 plus 3 upon 10. With this chart, it will be easy for you to understand. See, 929.312. 3 is on the 10th, 1 is on the 100th, and 2 is on the 1000th. TH. Alright, remember this. This is the place value chart for this. You must have studied in class 5th for this, isn't it? Now, like decimal number. Like decimal numbers having equal number of decimal place. So, for example, if you take this. 2.161. And here 2.002. Both is having thousandth. All right, here one is on the thousandth and here two is on the thousandth. So they are like decimal numbers. And if suppose that here you are not having any number, so this number is on the hundredth and this is on thousandth, so they both are unlike decimal numbers. So try always during the comparison, during the addition, subtraction or comparison, you have to make unlike decimal numbers into like decimal numbers. Remember this. All right. Now here, if these two numbers are given, 2.16 and 2.002. So here it is on the hundredth and here it is on the thousandth. So what you have to do is that to before comparison, you have to add one zero over here. The zero should be on the thousandth. Then you can easily compare which one is greater. Now here, look over here. Here on the 10th, you are having 0. Here on 10th, you are having 1. Here this part is same. So this value is greater than this because it is having 1 over here and it is here it is having 0. Now similarly, you can add also when you will convert it into like decimal numbers. Now the sequence is easy for you to add this way. Here 0, here 2, so 2, 6 plus 0 it gives you 6, 1 plus 0 gives you 1, 2 plus 2 gives you 4. So remember, a point should be in sequence. Similarly for subtraction as well, 0 is there, so we will take 1 from 6, so it will become 10, 10 minus 2 will give you 8, then here it is 5, 5 minus 0 will give you 5. Now here 1 will come up, 1 minus 0 will give you 1 and 2 minus 2 will give you 0. So 0.158. Clear? Now for the multiplication of decimal number. Now it's a rule, when you try to multiply two decimal numbers, alright, when you multiply two decimal numbers, what will happen, it will go, the numbers will be going this side, two decimals number when you are multiplying. But when you are dividing two decimal numbers, then the decimals will shift this side. Look over here. Can we write 2.16 as 216 upon 100 because it is on the 100th, so we can write. We can multiply two ends and make this as a non-decimal number. So this way, and here you are having on the thousand, means upon divided by thousand. Now multiply these two terms. Now you have all, I have already made you make you to know what is distributive law. So try to apply the law. Whatever you study, you try to apply on it. Now here, to make this form very simple, multiplication. Now I split 2002 into 2000 plus 2, so 216 into 2000 plus 216 into 2. This way, now count, here you are having 2 0, here you are having 3 zeros, total 5 zeros. So count from here, 1 2 3 4 5, and put the decimal over here. See how the decimal shifted this side. But when you are multiplying, only, if there is the, if the on the multiplication side, if 0 is there on the another number, then the 0 will shift this side. And if a single number is there and if you are dividing with 100, so that time the 0 will the point will shift this side. All right, clear? So if I take this number into 100, So here on this you are having on the before in between 3 you are having point. So it will one with 1 0 it will come over here, and the with the another it will come over here finally, because you are having 2 0. So the answer will be 4336.5. Now during multiplication, decimal is shifted towards the right side, clear? But if you are multiplying two decimal numbers, then surely the decimal will move towards the left side. It's a rule, all right? Now this chart, the comparison, how you will be converting, this will help you. This you have already studied in a measurement chapter in class 5th as well. How different units. The year, look over here. I had made it simple for you. I had used mass and volume and length. All right, with different units. So the difference between each is 10 each, and this is the left side. Look over here. This is the left. This is the right side. Now, if you are trying to convert from left to the right, all right, you will be dividing with zeros, whatever will be the denomination. For example, if you are taking 1 mg, converting into 1 mg to gram, so how many zeros are here? 3 zeros. So 1 upon 1000 grams. If you are taking 1 cg to gram, 1 cg to gram, it means 1 upon 100. 2 zeros are there. Similarly, if you are moving from right to the left side, you will be simply multiplying it. For example, 1 kg is equals to how many gram? 1000. See in the number of zeros, count 1, 2, 1, 2, 3 till gram, isn't it? So here you will be doing the multiplication part. I hope this chart will be easy for you to do the conversions. Now decimal of division of decimal numbers. This is the number you have to divide with this. Now look over here. It is having on the hundredth, and this is having the denominator part is having the on the thousand. So try to shift the decimals and make the number non-decimal. So try to shift the decimals step by step. I have shifted it, and finally here you will be getting, here till now the denominator is still having one decimal. I mean it is on the last digit. Now for that I have multiplied with 100 to make both the numbers as non-decimal numbers. Now this will be the number, and after that divide it. Now see the division. You can do this way, it will be easy for you. Now if you have, you are dividing this number with 1000, so what will happen? See, the decimals are shifted as what I have discussed. It will be shifted. Now 3 times it will be shifting. So here it is on the 100th. Now it will shift to the 3 times it will shift. See, one time, now on the second time it will shift from 9. And the third time it will shift from 9 to 2. So 0.29556. Clear? Now during division, the decimal is shifted towards the left side. Clear? Now for the baud mass. Baud mass I have already discussed in chapter first. Let me see. Here I have already discussed in chapter first in integers. Numerical expression, numbers and expression is written the different operators. The priority basis, B stands for bracket, O stands for of, D stands for division, M stands for multiplication, A stands for addition, S stands for subtraction. And in that bracket, first priority is given to line brackets. Line will be there. Then the second part is common bracket. Third is braces, and the fourth is big bracket. Clear? Now come on this part. Now if I take this question, how to solve it? We have to solve this part. Here it is having big bracket and this curly ones, common, and the line bracket as well. Alright, all the this part is given in this. Now how to do step by step, what you have to do, we will convert first the mixed fractions into improper fractions. And here I have done it, look over here, I have first converted all the mixed fractions into improper, and then here I started doing the operation. My first operation started from here, and similarly I am doing over here as well, because it is within the braces and nothing is there, no effect will be there, so I was doing it over here as well. Now after doing the operation, it comes 7/6. Now it within the braces, I am doing it. Now I will take the LCM of 3 and 6, it will come 6. Now 3 into 2 gives 6, so 2 into 8 gives 16, and 6 into 1 gives 6, 1 into 7 gives 7 only. Now this will come here, I can do make it into a simpler form. Now 3/2, it will make our calculation more easy. So now here with this I will take here 1, so I can take 2. Now this 1 into 2, so 2 will be multiplied with 6, that will give 12, and 2 into 1 gives 2, 1 into 3 gives 3. Now 9/2, now I will open this braces, this part is also clear. Now in this the LCM will be 6. Now again 3 into 2 gives 6, 2 into 14 will give 28. Now 2 into 3 gives 6, 3 into 9 will give 27. Now do this part, it will come over here like this, and now we will take the LCM of 72 and 6, the LCM will come 72. Now with this LCM, 72 into 1 gives 72, that 1 will be multiplied with the numerator of 35, that will give you 35, then 6 into 12 is 72, 12 into 1 gives 12. So 35 minus 12 will give you 23/72. This way to do the board mass, which I have already discussed in chapter 1. Alright. Now the exercise, few questions so that your concept will be easy. Now the first question, convert mixed fraction into improper fraction. Now this is the mixed fraction. What you have to do? You have already studied, and I have already taught you how to do, how to, this is a dividend, you have to find the dividend. So how you will find, this is the divisor, denominator part, this middle part is the quotient, and this part is the remainder. So 3 into 9, that is 27, plus 2, that is 29, 29/3, it is converted, it's an improper fraction in which the numerator is bigger than the denominator. Now similarly, if you have to convert this into mixed fraction, what you have to do? You have to divide with 29. So the quotient will come 9 and the remainder will left 2. So 2 will be on the upper side, 3 will be as it is, where it is. Now 9 will come in the middle part, as this example. You can convert into mixed into improper and improper into mixed. Now find the missing number in the below equivalent fraction. Now suppose that these two numbers are given, and in the another side this number is given, but here you have to find what I have told you, that you can cross multiply and check whether the fractions are equivalent like fractions or not. For that, here you try to, you are not knowing the value, try to put x. Now multiply 234 into x and 39 into 36, that should be same. So now try to multiply it, and here 36 into 39 into 234 into x. Now x here, this part will go in the denominator part. Now you can do the cancellation part, and 6 will come. Now 6 will be here, which was asked. All right. Now convert the fraction into simpler form. You have to divide with the same. Here 65 upon 156. Divide with the same numbers as many times you can to make it in the least form. But you have to remember, you will be dividing the same numbers. All right. In the numerator and denominator part. So here I took the 13. 13 I divided it with 65. That will give you 5, and 156 divided by 13, because 13 I am taking in both the numerator and denominator, so it will give 5. Now they both, now this is a prime number, so now it can't be further divided. So this is the simplest form, 5 upon 12. Now convert the following fraction into equivalent like fraction. This I have already discussed. For this, you have to make this unlike fractions into like fractions. Then only you can compare, and for that you have to take the LCM. Now you will be taking LCM for 7, 14 and 2. 2 start with the 2, 1 you are not taking because the resultant won't be affected. So we take it as 2. 2 you will try to do it. 7 you cannot divide. 14 yes, you can divide with 7 and 2 with 1. After that, you will take, now you cannot take it with 3, 4, 5, 6, now take it with 7, 7 you do it, here all will be 7, 1, so now 2 into 7, that is give you 14, so 14 will be the LCM. Now 14 you try to take it, 7 into 2 will give you 14, that's 2 will be multiplied with the numerator part and make use the separator, and then with 1, 13 into 1, then 7 into 17, 8, 3 and 19, they all are having a common denominator, that is 14. Now it will be easy for you to compare. Alright, this will come. Now above, arrange the above in ascending order. Now it is simple for you, all the denominators are same, so just you have to see on the numerator part which is smaller and which is bigger. Now 8 is the smallest among them, that will be here, then middle part 13, the numbers are as it is in the sequence only, so 8 upon 14 is smaller than 13 upon 14 and which is smaller than 119 upon 14. And then after that, make it into a simpler form, 4 upon 7, 13 upon 14, 17 upon 2. Now arrange the fractions into descending order. The same rule you will apply just after doing this. This is the biggest. So this will come up first. This is greater than this, and this is greater than this. All right. Now Maria spent 1 by 3 of the money of the money her grandparents gave her on an adventure book. All right, she also spent 1 by 9 of the money on a bag of candies. What fraction of the payment has Maria spent? Maria spent money portion on her grandparents' adventure book, 1 by 3. Maria spent money portion on a bag of candy. You will add here, this problem is for addition, you will add 1 by 3 plus 1 by 9, that will give you, now you have to take the LCM of 3 and 9, that is 9. Now 3 into 3, 3 into 1 will give you 3, 9 into 1 gives you 9, and 1 into 1 will give you 1, so 3 plus 1 will give you 4 upon 9. This is the answer. Total Maria spent 4 by 9. Amritansh solved 5 by 7 part of an exercise. Rachit solved 2 by 5 part of an exercise, and Astha solved 1/10 part of an exercise. Who solved most and least part, and by how much? Now Amritansh solved part of an exercise 5 upon 7 or 5 by 7. Rachit solved part of an exercise 2 by 5. Astha solved part of exercise 1 by 10. Now, these are the unlike fractions. you will try to convert into like fractions, then only you can compare who solved most and least. So after taking the LCM is 70, you will multiply it. The part of rough work I have already done over here, it will be easy for you to understand. Then after making the denominator common, now we have to look only just the numerator part. 50 is bigger than 28, and 28 is bigger than 7. So 50 upon 70 means 5. We will make it into simpler form, 5 by 7. 5 by 7 is Amritansh part. So he solved most of the part. And here 1 by 10 is Astha, who scored the least. Now we have to make by how much the difference from, 5 upon 7 minus 1 upon 10. You will be here. You have to take the LCM part. You will take the LCM of, or we do not have to take, because I have, you can take this part as well, because you have already taken the LCM, so no need to do too many times. So you can take 50 upon 70 minus 7 upon 70. 70 will be the common LCM. 50 minus 7 will give you 43. 43 upon 70. Now you cannot further divide it. So that will be the difference part. Now Mr. Mukherjee gave 5 by 14 of his money to his son, 2 by 3 of the remainder to his daughter, and the rest to his wife. If his wife got 36,000, what was the total amount? Mr. Mukherjee gave portion of his money to his son is 5 by, see over here, 5 by 14. Let the money be 1, the remaining will be 1 minus 5 upon 14. You will take the LCM of 14, because here you are not having anything. 1 is there, so 1 and 14, the LCM will be, it will be 14 only. Now 9 by 14 will come from the remaining 2/3 to his daughter. Now from the remaining, this was the remaining, so 2/3 of this means you have to multiply. Multiply means you can make it and reduce the fraction into 3 upon 7 will come. Alright, now to his wife, remaining was already 9 upon 14 minus this new one, 3 upon 7. That will give you, now you will take the LCM, and after taking the LCM, this will be coming 3 by new one, new part will be coming 3 upon 14 into total amount is equals to wife got 36,000. So now you will do the cross multiplication. This 14 will go and multiply with this, and total amount you have to find, and this 3 will be divided. So this will be coming 1,68,000 will be the answer. Now to find the value of 1 upon, this is a mixed fraction, so convert it into an improper fraction. Before solving, there is one rule: A divided by B divided by C divided by D. So this D will jump up on the A part, and this C will multiplied over here. So A into D upon B into C. Remember, this is the rule. Why I am doing? Because in your book, the answer is wrong. Now here, 1 upon 30 divided by 7 divided by 1. We can assume it. So this 1 will come up. Look over here, and this 7 will stay with 30 in the denominator. With the similar way, you will do this. After getting this, you will take the LCM. The LCM will be this. Then we will take 210 into 156 will give you 32,760. And with this way, you will try to take out, and this will be the answer for it. Now Renu complete 1/3 part of her homework in 5 hours. How much part of her homework had she completed in 3 by 4th hour? See, for this I am going to tell you one shortcut of unitary method. Try to put the part of her homework this side and time over here. Now part of homework 1 by 3 in 5 hours. So how much in this 3 by 4th hour, how much part she will complete? So you have to do the cross multiplication this side,
and try to this side can x into 5 hours and 3 by 4th hour into 1 by 3. See, hour and time part have separated into two different blocks. All right. Now, the moment you will try to multiply with this, it will become 1 by 4 hour. And here 5 hour into x. Now again you have to find the value of x. This 5 hour will go over here. Look over here. This 1 will come up. And 4 into 5 hour. This hour will be cancelled. So 1 by 20 part. 1 by 20 part of the homework will be done in 3 by 4 hours. Clear? Look over here. The answer will come this side. Now convert this into mixed fraction. What you have to do, this part you don't touch it, all right? From where the decimal is, just try to put, see, it is on the thousand part, so it is divided by thousand. Now try to simplify both into a simpler form. Divide by 25, both the, it will come this. Now it can't be further divided, so this part will be the mixed fraction form. Now express a 5 centimeter into meter and a kilometer. 1 centimeter is equals to 1 by 100 as per the chart which I have already shared to you. It will be easy for you to understand. 5 centimeter is equals to 5 upon 100 meter. This will come 1, 2. So here on the second place it will come the decimal part, so 0.05 meter. Similar way you can convert into kilometer as well. The product of two decimal number is 1.50 and one of the one of them is 0.250. Find the other number. Let the other number be x. One number is already given, so product of two number is 1.5. we can make this equation 0.250 into x is gives you 1.50. now you can easily find. Now here look, here I have just done multiplied with 100. So for the decimal will come over here, which is not required. If nothing is there after this, so we can simply write 25 here. Now 25 into 6 gives you 150. So 6 will be the x, the another number. A drum of petrol is 3/4 full. When 30 liters of oil are drawn from it, it is 7/12 full. Find the capacity of drum. A drum fill of petrol, this much oil drawn 30 liter. After drum is full, this much remaining is from this to this into total capacity is equals to 30 liter. This will come up. All right, you will solve it. And after that it will come 1 by 6 into total capacity of 30 liter. Just 6 will be multiplied to this and it will turn. The total capacity is equals to 180 liter. Clear? Now the last one. This is the question in which decimals are given. You have to solve it. Either you can solve it, simplify it. Look over here how to simplify it. Here it is having the numerator is having one decimal and here it is having two. Shift one here and here. Now it is 16.53. Now here also try to shift here it is having one. Try to shift one this side. Now 189 upon 1.5. now here still you are having 1 point, so you shift it from there as well. All right, so all the numbers are having non-decimal numbers. They all these four are having non-decimals. So try to cancel it, try to divide with the same numbers, upper and the lower, I mean numerator and denominator. This you will be getting 945. Now here also in the within the bracket you have to solve first. So two zeros will be cancelled, 151 will come. Try to subtract from 945 this 750. Then again 600 you have to subtract 600 as well, which is 150 minus 600, that is 750 total. Subtract it and then here look over here, this I gave just for for your understanding that if this is there, if two commons are here, both are same, one, so 87 plus 1 it will become, all right? Remember this. Or if you solve it also and if you cancel, 88 will come, means 264 it will come, and 264 divided by 3 it will come 88. Or you can do directly, you can simplify it and add with this here, where is the quotient part. All right, now minus with 945 and add 88. 945 minus 750 plus 88, the answer will come 283. I hope the whole explanation is clear to you all, and if you have any doubt, you are free to ask. Thank you.